Hello, B here. Welcome back to biology. Before we jump into unit 2, you and I each need to find a living thing we can use as an example. Now, where can I find a living thing? Wait, I'm living. Well, that was easy, and you're living too, or at least I hope you are, so you can use yourself as an example. Now that we have our living examples, we can begin Unit 2 with a question. What is your living body made of? Maybe you're thinking of body parts like your head, arms, and fingers. Or maybe you're thinking about the materials your body is made of, like bone, skin, and blood. If we focus on these materials, what are they made of? What are the building blocks of blood? Are they the same as the building blocks of bone or even other living materials like leaves? And are living materials made of the same building blocks as non-living materials like a rock or a smartphone? The answer is yes and no. And we'll need some basic chemistry to understand why. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to define matter, describe the structure of atoms, and explain what makes atoms of one element different from atoms of another element. Let's come back to our examples of living and non-living materials. When you're holding your non-living smartphone in your living hand to send a text, you're actually holding matter with more matter. Matter is any substance that has mass and takes up space. Your phone has mass and takes up space, so it must be matter. Similarly, all of your body parts and body materials have mass and take up space. So you are matter too. Matter exists in different states, including solid, liquid, and gas. There are some other weird ones too, but we won't get into those right now. Living things contain and interact with matter in all three of these states. For example, bones and tree branches are solids. As for liquids, more than half of a human's body weight is from liquid water. Water performs essential functions in living things. For example, water inside our bodies helps produce other important life liquids like blood. And gases? Well, we interact with them every time we take a breath. Continuously exchanging gases with the environment is an essential life process for most living things, including plants and animals. Okay, so all living materials, as well as non-living materials, are examples of matter. But what is matter actually made of? We have to zoom in really close to answer that question. Not on me, guys. That camera isn't able to see my building blocks, and my atoms aren't ready for their close-up anyway. That's right. I'm made of atoms, and so are you. Atoms are the building blocks of matter, including living materials like us. And they're small, really small. Let's consider a small piece of matter, like a grain of sand. How many atoms do you think make up a single grain of sand? The answer is a lot. There are more than 40 quintillion atoms in a single grain of sand, which is this number. That's a lot of zeros. Atoms are way too small for us to see with the naked eye, and are even too small to see through most microscopes. Only our most powerful microscopes can visualize atoms, and even they can only show an outline. This is an image of carbon atoms taken by a very powerful microscope. Each one of those blurry blobs is an atom. If we could see these atoms in even more detail, what would they look like? Scientists know from experiments that atoms have a central part called a nucleus. The nucleus is very small compared to the size of the atom, but contains almost all of the atom's mass. The nucleus is made of two types of particles, protons and neutrons. These are called subatomic particles because they are even smaller than atoms and make up an atom's structure. Finally, atoms contain a third type of subatomic particle called electrons. Electrons are even smaller and less massive than protons and neutrons. They are located not in the nucleus, rather they exist in the space around the nucleus in the electron cloud. The electron cloud has almost no mass, but makes up most of the space of an atom. Okay, so atoms are really small, but are they all the same? Nope! And that's a good thing because you and I, along with all of the other beautiful life on Earth, could not exist if all atoms were the same. That's because life requires different elements to function. I bet you already know of some different elements. Can you think of any? If you named any of these guys, you are correct. This is the periodic table. It shows all of the known elements, of which there are currently 118. Some of them may sound familiar, like hydrogen, helium, carbon, oxygen, and even gold. Fancy! Every element has an abbreviation shown in the periodic table. Some of them are easy to guess, like carbon's abbreviation, C. But others seem more random, like gold's abbreviation, AU. It's not really random though. AU comes from the Latin word for gold, aurum. So, what about atoms? How do they relate to all of these different elements? It's actually pretty simple. The elements represent varieties of atoms, and every atom is a member of only one element. Think of the element as the atom's name. For example, this is an atom of carbon. Nice to meet you, carbon. And how do I know this is an atom of carbon and not, say, hydrogen or oxygen? It's all about the number of protons. The elements on the periodic table are arranged from left to right by how many protons are in their nuclei. By the way, nuclei is the plural form of nucleus. I wasn't just making up a weird word. Anyway, since hydrogen is the first element, we know that any atom which has only one proton in its nucleus must be a hydrogen atom. Any atom that has two protons must be helium. Any atom that has three protons must be lithium. Any atom that has six protons must be carbon, and so on. The number of protons in an atom's nucleus is like a name tag, an identifier that tells us which element it belongs to. So, let's go back to our questions from the beginning of the video. What is your living body made of? More broadly, what are all living materials made of? And are they made of the same building blocks as non-living material? We now know that all materials, including the materials that make up living things, are examples of matter because they have mass and take up space. We also know that since atoms are the building blocks of matter, living things must be made of atoms. All atoms contain a central nucleus surrounded by an electron cloud. Finally, we know that not all atoms are the same and belong to different elements, depending on the number of protons in their nuclei. So, are we and other living things built of atoms of all elements or just some elements? And are atoms of some elements more common in living things than others? Don't worry. We'll get into that in the upcoming lessons. But for now, just know that when I say that you matter, it's true in more ways than one. Until next time, remember, biology is more than just science, it's the way of life. Hey, hey.